श्रीमती रामानुजाय नमः। टुडे इज अ डिस्कशन ऑन पल्स डायग्नोसिस। जस्ट एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड अबाउट क्लाइमेट चेंज अबाउट इट्स idiomatic as well as casual usage. Pulse is also having casual usage and idiomatic usage. Pulse of a country, pulse of the economy, pulse of the system. So the operation status and standard of a system is called as pulse, and it is based on only this biological experience from pulse diagnosis. And what pulse diagnosis or the pulse interpretation or the pulse indication that refers to? It is not the representation of a singular system or a singular dimension or the single experience of a system. It is the study of the impact of the collective interpretations of various messages from various systems and dimensions that are operating on various levels. If pulse diagnosis, it deals with the pulse interpretation or indication of a particular system, which is called central nervous system or circulatory system or excretory system or the skeletomuscular system, then certainly we should have different pulse rates at different various places. So there are three things. One is locally fixed, and the second thing is that has a common collective indicator. Third thing is merge mechanism, in which various indications they merge at a common center. So on this basis, the interpretation or indication that is given by a particular part of the body, that should be only from that particular part. That is rule number one. And rule number two, that will have the impact on a different part, whereby you are realizing those things in the impact center. The third thing, there is a common information center like TTD information center, in which you can get all tickets for all sevas. There is a common information center which gives you the reflective message or impulse of the totalitarian activities that are taken by different systems of the body. For example, if there is any heart problem, according to local standard theory, you must feel the heart variations only through the heart or the heart connected area, number one. If the heart connected area creates a morbid impact on some other areas by means of this palpitation, you are getting giddiness, then you can have the impact on your head. Then you can feel some sort of nervous debilitation or some anxiety by which you can feel it in the impact area. One is the morbid zone, third thing is the impact zone, and in between there is a common information zone which is known as pulse. If you want to know about a disease, you can understand from the same organ, that is known as morbid zone. You cannot understand from that organ. For example, lot of organs are hidden inside. Regarding eye, you can see eye infection. Without seeing the pulse, you can say that somebody is infected with the eye. Nasal congestion. And all of these other various peripheral substances of the body, we can understand from the morbid region itself. Second thing is impact. For example, somebody is having a swelling. That is an impact of any tooth infection. Or some other thing that is happening to an adjacent part of the body. And even due to overheat that is there emanated in the whole body structure, we can see reddish eyes. Whatever we are seeing now as a form of inflammation in the jaws due to tooth infection, that is based on adjacent principle. That is known as adjacent principle. And the second thing is that which is there totally in the body system itself is reflected in a particular area. That is number two. Number three, an internal system. For example, if you are ulcerated in the mouth, that indicates you are ulcerated in the intestine. Without intestinal ulceration, you cannot get mouth ulcer. Unless due to any other consumption or various other external thing, any other inherent ulceration of the mouth, the inner cavity of the mouth, it immediately indicates that the intestine has been ulcerated. So we have to understand, understanding diseases is from either the direct affected area or the impact area or from a common information center. And even the impact area is of three types. It is an impact of a totalitarian body change, like climate change, like the body heat that induces redness in the eyes. That is totalitarian. Adjacent means like you are having tooth infection, you are having some inflammation in the mouth. Third thing, distant, remote or connective. You are having intestinal ulceration, so you are reflecting the same thing in the form of ulceration inside your mouth. So we are having morbid impact and common information centers in impact also, because this is the foundation for pulse diagnosis. That's why I'm repeating it. And also in impact, there is adjacent impact, there is totalitarian impact, and there is a destinal, connective, relative, or internal systemic impacts. So these things are the three reasons on the basis of which particular ideology of pulse diagnosis is based. It is a common information center by which you can get signals, co-signals, sub-signals, sub-co-signals, co-sub-signals, co-co-signals, sub-sub-co-signals of innumerable dimensional clarity. One has to perceive all of these things, feel all of these things, interpret all of these things, and fix the disease and the disease's gravity by means of which he has to go for the medication prescription. So this is how we have to understand pulse diagnosis. Pulse diagnosis is not a system by which a partial, selective, or organic interpretation of any disease is explained. It is understanding of five divisions. One, causative factor for the disease. Number two, the tenure of the disease, exposed and to be exposed. The fatality rate of the disease. The loci of the disease. What is loci of the disease? In which organ, in which system, in which channel, in which tissue, where is the morbid spot? That is the loci. And fifth thing is fixation of the pharmacogenomic customized natural principal status of a human being, so that customized medicine can be given to that person. Interpreting a person, like identity of a person as vice chancellor, as a human being, as a collector, as a singer, these things are various cultural, social identities. Likewise, who is the person? Apart from a biological address of a person, what is the medical identity of the person? It is understood by Pancha Bhuta Jnana, Pancha Prana Jnana, Tri Dosha Jnana, Varmasthana Jnana, Marmasthana Jnana, Shat Chakra Jnana, which forms the substratum of the microanatomy as well as infraanatomy and paraanatomical studies of Ayurveda. So pulse diagnosis is the process of interpreting organs, systems, channels, tissues, and morbid spots by means of having a very limited area of operation in which all the finest sublingual, sub-sublingual interpretations are handled by means of a person's super excellency and hyper dexterity. That is known as pulse diagnosis. And it is very difficult for any person to believe that now we are having innumerable systems of operation with diagnosis. There are three things. First thing is studying the system, that is systemics, by means of anatomy, physiology, and various other structures. Number two is diagnosis. Third thing is medical treatment, which is based on pathology, which is divided into, that is endocrinology, gastrology, stomatology, innumerable divisions are there, cardiology, nephrology, urology, neurology, neurobiology, neuropsychiatry, psychiatry, innumerable sciences are there. So the second portion is diagnosis, which is very essential, and without proper diagnosis, understanding of the knowledge of medicine in systemic science as well as understanding of the treatment, both will be collapsed. And at the cost of your experimentation or ignorance or trial, the person, that is the patient, will be put into trial and trouble. So pulse diagnosis is very significant, and it is very hard to believe that what are the symptoms now we have. One is the physical symptom or the visible symptom. Second thing is by the narration, the person narrates his experiences. And third thing is comparison, yukti, what we have seen in the similar people before. And fourth thing is decision or nirnaya. Pratamam drishti syat. First we are having drishti, we are seeing the person. Second is narration, that is anubhuti. Like pida, asaukya, sukha, akshema, vyavritya adayaha. what are the conveniences, inconveniences, adaptability, inadaptability that the person experiences from his narration. First is perception, what you see. Second is narration, what he says. Comparison is your record, mutuality of match with all of your experience in your mental records that you are subjected for experimentation. Then to arrive at a proper decision without sacrificing the person's life or the person's convenience to survive. So this is the thing. Apart from which, there are also innumerable methods. We can see what is there inside by means of x-rays now. Penetrative vision is there. We can see what the things are there. Apart from symptom, narration, comparison and decision, we are not capable of seeing the heart. We are not capable of seeing the inner parts of the body. We are seeing only outer reflection and there are signals. How to see that? There is a penetrative vision by means of x-rays, endoscopy, laparoscopy, innumerable things that have come. Just to see, verify, measure, ascertain and operate. Five operations have come by means of machines. We can see, we can measure what is happening inside. How much it is there, albumin, sugar level, urea level, we can measure things. Can we measure through nadi? Yes, we can measure. But the problem is there is nobody to measure. There is nothing to measure in medical science because their fundamental is wrong. There is nobody to measure in spite of the fundamental being correct in Ayurveda. These are all the problems in modern medicine. Nobody to measure, nobody to evaluate precisely. So we can see, we can measure. There are three methods, invasive, semi-invasive and non-invasive methods by which bioscopy is there, endoscopy is there, laparoscopy is there. Innumerable scopies are having their scopes in penetrating, measuring, identifying and implementing the medical tools. There is a question which is frequently asked, even I can ask the question. Thousands of millions of dollars are invented in establishing medical labs. And thousands of dollars are given totally as a global clinical expense or expenditure by a lot of people for these checkups. Regarding invention and novel identity and technology in discovering new medicines and new technical methods for diagnosis, they have already invested thousands of dollars. Thousands of dollars already invented. Thousands of dollars put in expenditure by patients, the honorable patients of the society. Thousands of more dollars are invested there in further invention and discovery. And it is very hard to believe that within a small area of your thumb level, in the artery waves of your wrist, beneath that, by just pressing three fingers, if you can identify the same interpretation of these things, which they have spent innumerable knowledge resources, financial resources, for several decades, if you can manage the same thing with this thing, either it must be a myth or a wonder in the world. It replaces thousands of dollars of expenses. Thousands of dollars of expenses for investment, further investment and research. Innumerable things are being done in the world. If this pulse diagnosis is going to replace effectively, I can immediately say, without seeing any of the reports that are there with the x-ray and various other penetrative measures, without the aid of any modern tools, if I can replace my prediction or disease prognostics, without the aid of these costly methods, then totally it proves two things. One, the total investment of the world is vain. Those people, they are either mature, either immature, or they are ignorant in understanding the value of pulse diagnosis. These things are the real two causes. But to prove that real causes, we have to extirpate the myth or the illusion that is in the society. That is the third point. First thing is they are spending in vain. They are ignorant. The third is the accusation of them towards us. We are superstitious, we are obscure, we are unprovable and non-scientific. That is the third allegation. That allegation is on Ayurveda. If this allegation is proved, then we can say that the world is ignorant and the modern westernized society has failed to understand because of its immaturity or imbecilism to understand the most valuable, intricate and intrinsic principles of the natural cosmobiology and biocosmology. Anta pinda vijnana, pinda anta vijnana. We have to prove this third thing. And how to understand from this pulse? There is a position, there is a place, there is a dimension, there is a systemic way of understanding by placement. So it is on place, position, placement and dimension. These four things are very essential. And there are three types of interpretation. Normalcy interpretation, circumstantial influence, biological, psychological, biopsychological, psychoecological influence. This nadi are the pulse rate, rhythm, speed, gravity, intermittence, flow. All of these factors are affected by these three things. One is psychological, Second thing is ecological. Third thing is biological. This biological influence is known as morbidity or malady. Problem is known as malady, and the result or the solution is known as remedy. So if you want to understand these things, certainly we have to classify who is in normalcy and who is having physical problem and where there is a reflection. For example, somebody tested their diabetic level. It was 320. Then I told that your anxiety of knowing your sugar levels, that would have contributed at least 50 points. And I asked where he is coming from. He told that he was driving in a traffic, and yesterday night only he traveled from some other place, and the whole night he did not sleep properly. So the physical tension that has been caused, also the strain of his driving, care, and various ways of vigilance that he practiced at the time of his tense emotion at the time of driving, as well as the anxiety, palpitation, and perplexity that he has developed at the time of being tested, naturally that should have induced that. So psychological rate, ecological rate, and morbid region, malarial rate, they must be very much classified. It is common both to Ayurveda people as well as modern practitioners. So whenever your pressure or sugar is measured, you can understand that it is eco plus psycho plus bio. And how much is eco, how much is psycho, for that you want to get some clarity, which we will define in some workshops, not possible in these things. So how to operate these things? One person should know what is normalcy. If he cannot understand what is normalcy, for example, even in the Vata, there is pranapana vyana udana samana. Even there is a chetaka, puraka, nirodhaka, rodhaka, bodhaka, khadaka, sleshaka, innumerable types of vatas, pittas, and kaphas are there. So they have to differentiate these various interpretations of normalcy. Most of the people, they are normal, number one. Number two, 3 points, golden rules of health, you have to understand. Each and every person has a normal standard, one. Each and every person has normal elasticity standard. What is normal elasticity standard? Even a person within the power or ambit of his resistance, he can be abnormal to a particular level. The body homeostasis will take care, that is known as ojas. The homeostasis will take care of his health, and he will be repatriated to normalcy very gradually, number two, automatically. Number three, that is plasticity of a person's ability of normalcy, in which if he takes rest, either avoids work or does a lighter type of work or refrains from certain activities, that normal rest will repatriate. So wherever automation, normalcy, automation, repatriation, settlement, and homeostatic ability, if 5 things fail, then only you have to go for medicines. So pulse diagnosis, immediately it should not start with medication. It should understand how much he is normal, and normalcy of a person is different from normalcy of others. Lot of people we have tested in our diabetology lecture, most of the people are naturally having low sugar with them. Most of the people genetically, hereditarily, occupationally, it is known as occupational therapy or occupational pathology. Based upon a person's tension, the area where he works, the amount of work that he executes, the amount of tension that is unavoidable in his responsibility, liability, and execution, these things are to be counted before counting everything. That is why it is known as grade. Pulse diagnosis that deals with your nature, specific nature. We cannot have a clinical, there are two records, clinical record and personal clinical record. Your personal clinical record will be plus or minus 10 to 15 points from clinical records, certainly. Because you are entirely different, no doubt you are part of the world, but you are having your individuality. Pratyekatha. On the basis of that pratyeka nyaya, that's why most of the people are living in the fear of disease rather than diseases. Most of the people living in the fear of diseases, living in the fear of more diseases. They are having two extremities. One, negligence about big diseases. Unwanted phobia or fear about unwanted diseases or casual diseases. So this is due to negligence by which they suffer, as well as due to overestimation of their own things, not including the biopsychological as well as the ecological record. They are considering that it is different. So what is your normalcy? Elasticity, plasticity, adaptability, internal curability, then go for drug. If it is not possible, go for divinity. If it is not possible, go for death and be born again. What is the problem? Are you clapping for the last solution? So how to do is that? This is known as Sapta Prakriya. How to do this Nari Pariksha? Sparsha, that is by touch. pressure, touch it, press it, move it, hold it, unhold it, rehold it. Yeah. These are known as sapta prakriyas. So, touch it, then press it. If the immediate touch cannot give you the message, press it. If that particular area does not give that, change it by a yava. That is a width distance to that area, you can feel it. With the tip of the area, back to feel, there are two points, feeling points. There are two feeling points. One is the revealing point and second is the feeling point. And feeling points are also two. Revealing point is your nadi, feeling point is your finger. Even in feeling point, there are two feeling points. You are just feeling it by your mind, also feeling it by your fingers. In between that fingers and mind, there is one internal additional force. The sound that you hear, where you can hear the sound? Which organ is meant for sound? Only here. It is the center of audition, but now you are feeling it in the finger because you cannot hear it by ears, because it is a spot-based sound emanation. It is a spot-based sound emanation. So unless you press your fingers here, the feeling sense, that is the thwak, the feeling sense, the touch sense of your body, that along with that of shruti or shravana, it is known as thwak srotra sambandha, or touch audition therapy, or touch audition methodology. You touch it, you are not fixing your ears, nobody is hearing like this. That is why even in stethoscope, it is based on two centers. One center is for the touch, second center is for audition. The same touch and audition and interpretation should be given, replacing the stethoscope by means of your psychoscope, by means of our intellectual scopic energy by which we have to analyze these things and interpret. So you have to do the work, that is a bidirectional work of both the ends of the stethoscope by your hands. So by touching, touch it. If you don't feel, press it. If you don't feel by pressing, change the position. If you don't feel, hold it. Then if you don't feel, unhold it, then rehold it. Within this prakriya, we can get the interpretation. And Vaidya should have Ashtama Siddhis in pulse diagnosis. Number one, there are certain factors which are even humorous. I told in one seminar, if the pulse is disturbed, you cannot have clear prediction. If the pulse rate of a person is disturbed, you cannot have clear prediction. Then somebody asked me, if the pulse is not disturbed, why we are coming here for prediction? Then I added that it is known as exomalarial influential factors. Apart from the malarial factors of your body, if there are additional disturbances of restlessness, exhaustion and other things, if you are not placid, if you are unexhausted, if you are totally in a mood to commit yourself for proper inspection, then only we can give you clear indication. So immediately if a person comes, he cannot be diagnosed like that. A person must be in a casual mode, in a calm mode. In either a non-executive, he must be neither sluggardish nor over-exhausted. So a proper mental, intellectual and physical balance, apart from the diseases, I'm saying, apart from the diseases, apart from that specific disturbance, no other disturbance must be available for clear inspection. It is first how to filter or distill exomalarial factors at the time of diagnosis. This is a prathama siddhi. Second thing is supportive lead or independent lead. It is a siddhi. What is supportive lead? For example, there are five symbols. One is a facial. Second is by tongue interpretation. Third is by lips. And fourth is by nail. And fifth is by eye. It is known as optical mode, sensitive mode, or facial mode, or nail. All of these things are just commonly observed. Initial observation, secondary observation, tertiary observation. In initial observation, face, tongue, lips, nail, and eye, they are considered. In secondary observation, the dhatuka, it is known as dhatuka pariksha, where a person's urine, where a person's blood, serum, and other things are considered for testing. That is secondary. Third thing is ahara, nidra, pita, jirna, ruthu, ityadayaha. Where his food intake, consumption level, taste response, digestion and vomiting or emetic sensation, menstrual discharge and its regularity, all of these various physiological explicit dimensions and demonstrations are made in the tertiary level. A person who is having supportive lead, by means of all of these things, he must take them as inputs and interpret the pulse. That is supportive lead. This is supportive lead. Independent lead is a person touching the pulse, he can interpret what is your ahara, what is your nidra, how you sleep, whether you are somnolent or insomnolent. There are innumerable levels: insomnia, hypersomnia, hyposomnia, semisomnia, somnambulism, innumerable reflections of appetite, digestion, and somnolence is there in medical record. By touching these things, a person can interpret the irregularity of the biological or biocollective function, that is independently. A person who can take all of these supportive factors, primary, secondary, and tertiary factors, and interpret the pulse level is known as supportive lead. So a person should have both the knowledge. Even though he cannot have independent lead, at least he should have a supportive lead. Without which he cannot do that. Number two. Number three, types of diseases. One, whether it is hereditary or accidental or incidental or infectious. Four levels of diseases. He must be having the skill. Fourth, stage of diseases. Predeterminal stage, determinal stage, detrimental stage, incubative stage, processive stage, hyperprocessive stage, mature stage, fatal stage. So he must understand the stage of the diseases, level of the disease, whether it is at tissue level, cell level, organic level, chromosomal, DNA or genome level. That is known as level interpretation of disease. And a person should also know how to interpret mind and intellect along with body reflections. That is the greatness of Ayurveda, in which the impact of mind on body and body on mind, psychobiology and biopsychology, or psychophysiology or physiopsychology, apart from this epistemopsychology or epistemopsychophysiology, psychophysioepistemology, then ontophysiopsychology, ontophysiopsychoepistemology. So sharira mana, mana sharira, sharira mana buddhi, buddhi mana, buddhi sharira mana buddhi atma, atma buddhi mana sharira. So this is the type of understanding. That's why Ayurveda is known as integral system. Apart from physical reflections, what is the influence of mind? What is the influence of the determination on mind and mind on the body? What is the soul? What is the karmic theory? And what is the declination of a person's status in his karmic level, which has causated the physiological degradation? That is there in Ayurveda. So a person should have karma mimamsa, dharma mimamsa, buddhi mimamsa, mana mimamsa, and sharira rachana shastra. Not mere sharira rachana shastra. That is also one great siddhi, mind and intellect understanding. Then he should be also capable of understanding, preventing, as well as postulating, as well as understanding with prognostic alarm, disease and disability. Immediate death, remote death. Immediate disability and remote disability. So all of these things are known as the various skills or specialized talents or ashtama siddhis for pulse diagnosis. There are innumerable pulse rates, just as we are having now the Hamsa Gati, then Manduka Gati, just as we are having three types of living beings. One is reptilia, second is amphibia, third thing is apes. So a reptilian pulse rate is known as a snake, and an amphibian is known as Manduka, that is Sarpa Gati and that is Manduka Gati. And an apes that floats, Plavati, Charati, Dhavati. Charatiti sarpa, as it crawls, it is known as sarpa. Sarpati means that which crawls with speed is known as sarpa. Dhavatiti manduka, as it jumps, that is known as manduka gati. Plavati, as it floats and crosses, it is known as hamsa gati. These three things are the major things. Apart from that, weak pulses, even in Chinese traditional Wang dynasty, even before 2000 years, they have developed a lot of diagrams and illustrative exercises for pulse diagnosis and pulse rates. How to identify? There are a lot of things given. They count it with Q energy, Qi energy, which flows into the body, just as we are considering it as ojas. There is a short energy, there is long pulse drive, there is immediate drive, there is intermittent drive, there is incessant drive, there is pulsative drive, there is causative drive, there is slippery drive. There are innumerable drives mentioned in Chinese traditional medicine. But what we want now is to create a new era of pulse diagnosis. We have just discussed with Rajan also. Number one, to develop this ideology or methodology of pulse diagnosis, in which you can identify this is multiple liver sclerosis. So you have to compositely understand all of these things. So to exactly specify that particular area, certainly you must know what are the main signals, what are the sub-signals, sub-sub-signals, I have already told. So you must know Anga, Moolanga, Uppanga, Uppanganga, Tatanga, Antaranga, all of these things are to be understood for interpretation. It will take even eye derivative lecture and Nadi Pariksha, and how to develop micro-sensitivity in your fingers. For example, if you want to hear and enjoy good music, you must have sensitivity to music. There must be sensitivity. Apart from audition, you must have some knowledge or personal interest. So there are three things: personal interest, knowledge and qualification that makes you to learn, not merely just having ears and eyes. Likewise, if you want to understand the pulse diagnosis, you can hear lap-tap-lap-tap. Apart from that, what you can understand? You can even interpret that Vata is more or Pitta is more. We can understand, we can say about their Taratamya or Alpadhikya. Alpa Samana Adhikya Taratamya Adayaha Samanyataraha Vidyante. By means of normal vision, we can even identify that it is Alpa, minimum, Samana, equal, Adhikya, it is more, Taratamya, up and down. All of these things, variations can be understood by mere practice. For interpretation, in place of the all later sophisticated mechanisms, at least he should have 20 years of experience. I delivered a lecture at an Ayurveda college, and the dean told, I have experimented even lakhs of patients since from my boy and studenthood. Till now, I don't know how to interpret exactly these things. So I used to send these people for normal examination through other modern methods, modern technical methods. So number one, there is total impossibility to create instantaneously incubate or produce people, those who are skillful in pulse diagnosis. It requires a lot of patience, a lot of learning and a lot of experience and exposure to innumerable patients. It is not immediately possible. And even as it is a person, if it is a machine is designable, we can make a die, we can have multiple or multi-level productivity and we can market, it is purchasable. Whereas knowledge with a particular person is not easily so transferable. Even if there are two or three people, to create as per the emerging need of the youthful patients of the society, it is not easy for us to manufacture or to market such level of skillful people. Even if you accept that you can make some people, to market them, make them available to the emerging society is impossible. So to make a mechanical or digital interpreter of pulse by means of artificial intelligence, especially by the methodology of creating that analytical tabulation that is fed in the form of a software-led microprocessor, which can make the person, no doubt the feeding must be given by a talented person, it can give us a clear record. So to create a substitution only, Swaminathan and Rajan and myself, we are working, and certainly INVAG will be more blissful and it will be more meritorious only if we produce something for which the world has a need, not by just speaking. This we can do. Because to feel that, we must have micro-sensitivity in feeling, in audition and interpretation. So cognosensitivity, audio sensitivity and touch sensitivity, it is very difficult to produce. So we can produce these things. I have suggested a method. It is known as reciprocal tabulation or reverse exercise philosophy. What is reverse exercise? By hearing these things, we have to do two major exercises. One, by making these signals immediately graspable and convertible into various levels of classification based on the signal depth. For example, first level, second level, third level, fourth level, fifth level, we can get the main signals, the sub-signals, the sub-sub-signals, I have already told. First, to disintegrate the signals into codes and prepare the algorithms for that, number one. Number two, instead of trying to interpret the pulse signals as diseases and their density and gravity, you take the pulse level of the already diseased patients and try to understand by a reverse method from disease to pulse rate interpretation. It is very easy. That's what I have suggested already. I think that we have to take this as our program also. We have discussed in CVT, that's the program of creating pulse diagnostic modern digital mechanism and software, and also by a reverse interpretation, I have told the same. And persons like Pense and Mr. Rajaya, those who are pestered with lot of experiments or exposures, lot of patients for study, for diagnosis as well as for clinical treatment, they must be having links. those people, they can create a reciprocal tabulation of both the things. One, if a person is suffering from a disease, how his pulse rate works, number one, it is entry. Second thing, the same signals, whether they occur to different patients for different diseases, number two. Number three, that is known as collateral entry. Third thing is contrary entry. The same disease giving various signals. So, karanantra karya samana, karyantra karana samana, tat karana tat karya, akarana akarya. So, we have to make these classifications. Karana karya karana, karana karana karya, so we can go like this. So, it is logical, practical, philosophical, medical and technical. So, we are going to do that. So, getting the entry of records, getting contrary interact of the same problems for different signals, the same signals for different problems, we have to work out. At least we can take diabetes, we can take asthma, we can take that is eosinophilia and sinusitis, either cardio asthma or cardio respiratory diseases or cardiac diseases. There are a lot of emerging and lot of abundant diseases in the society. So we can take such a common disease where we can get lot of patients. For example, bipolar is. If you take bipolar is, we can get only 2 patients per district or state. So take a common disease where everybody is struggling and kindly feed these tabulations. That is the message of me in this pulse diagnosis lecture. Certainly we have to do that, and within 2 months with this record, we have to conduct a second seminar in which we have more messages to say practically to the society, especially to the scientific community. We can prove that it has inner dimensions equal to that of the emerging technology. Now we are having 3 things in emerging technology. One is false diagnosis. False diagnosis. They diagnose the results as something else. They are misinterpreting, due to which the people are misled. Even the doctors, they are misled by their own improper ways of diagnosis. So that is false diagnosis. Second is insufficient diagnosis. They diagnose this thing, but they are not understanding the cause for that. Third thing is obscure. They don't know what the disease is. There are a lot of syndromes like that. There are more than 363 unidentified diseases and syndromes that is there for the World Health Center. X syndrome, Y syndrome, Z syndrome, Q syndrome, innumerable things are there. So we have obscure things, we have insufficient predictions, and we have misguiding interpretations. So to create a dawn in the field of diagnosis which can enable proper treatment, to show to the scientific community, we can start with a simple mechanism of reciprocal tabulation, which is handed over to these people, that is the talented practitioners, as well as to scientific people like Swaminathan and E.G. Rajan. We have to take the way of understanding, the way of physics, as well as signal processing and interpretation by means of a mechanical digital software methodology, by which this can be processed by means of an algorithmic coding and decoding or encoding methods, by which we can arrive at the real interpretation through pulse diagnosis and prove that this small area, you know that Veena is a very big instrument and that can cover all music, you know that. A guitar is something smaller than that, still it covers the same areas. But the intricacy is more. Mandolin is still more small. It covers everything. Mouth horn is still small. It covers the same thing, the same tune you can play. Likewise, it is a small space which covers the mysteries, uncountable myriads of mysteries of human life, longevity, and their salubrity. That is a very small area. The area of 3 points of your 3 tips of the fingers, you have the message for the whole community, and we can only give. We don't require big monitors and a lot of computerized systems. With the 3 spots, with the 3 pin spots in a very smaller area, we can cover the whole global functioning of the biological systems, and we have to prove the greatness and glory of our nation to the world. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.